Hey guys, I'm at the Shore Temple in Mahabalipuram, and this is the world's oldest lingam, built more than 1300 years ago. We can see right away that there is something very unusual about this lingam. It looks like it has been created with machines. This is because this structure is made of 16 equal sides. Now, on the top, you can see that it has been badly damaged. This is because kings of other faith have tried to destroy this lingam a few hundred years ago. Today, it stands about 5 feet tall, but the original structure stood 12 feet tall. Is this structure made with ancient machining technology or with primitive tools like chisels and hammers? The baffling feature of this structure is that it is made of 16 equal sides. This type of structure is called a hexadecagon. It is impossible to make a perfect monolithic hexadecagon of this magnitude with primitive tools. Today, we can make different polygons using computer-controlled machines, but cutting a 12-foot rock with 16 equal sides would not be easy even with machines. The biggest problem with creating a perfect hexadecagon is not the length or the width of the facets. These can be measured with simple tools, but the problem lies in creating the perfect angle between the sides. To make a structure with just 8 sides, we would have to calculate the exact angle between each side, which would be 135 degrees. Now, this lingam has twice the number of sides, which means that the angle between each side should be 157.5 degrees. Now, there is a decimal point in degrees. Is this lingam really perfect, or does it merely look perfect? If this entire structure was made with chisels and hammers, there would be some human error. So I decided to calculate the angle between the facets. If this is a perfect hexadecagon, the angles between all the sides should be exactly 157.5 degrees. Here you can see my measurement with an angle finder. You can see that there is no error, and it shows the perfect angle of 157.5 degrees. I've measured all sides, and they're all absolutely equal. This quote-unquote modern instrument that I use today doesn't show me decimal places, but you can see that this black line is always halfway between these two lines. So, you can imagine what kind of advanced instruments were used 1300 years ago by ancient builders. I've also measured the width of all sides, and they're all perfect down to the millimeter. This means there's absolutely no human error in the structure, which proves that this structure was made with advanced machinery. But there is another structure which is more baffling than this 16-faceted lingam. There's a 16-faceted structure called colosseum sitting on top of the temple tower. Making a regular hexadecagon requires straight machining. But what we see on the very top of this temple tower needs much more complex machining because of the varying shapes and grooves. It looks like a metal structure, but it is actually made of stone. This colosseum looks tiny from here, but it is in fact 6 feet tall. It just looks tiny because of the height of the tower, which is 60 feet. And if you zoom in, you can see the 16 facets and the varying shapes created to perfection. Such complex design with 16 facets would be impossible without the help of advanced machines and tools. What kind of technology was used back then, and why do we have no mention of this technology in history books? Now, the fascinating feature is that while the entire structure is made of granite, which is locally available, the lingam and the colosseum are not made of granite. They are made of a type of rock called black basalt, which is not available anywhere within an 800-mile radius. Why did they take such pains to transport black basalt from a faraway land and use it on specific structures? If you look carefully, we can see why. You can see that the blocks made of granite show lots of corrosion because of the salty sea breeze. However, there is no sign of corrosion on the Colosseum or the Lingam because black basalt does not corrode. This is why the most critical pieces of the temple were made with black basalt. The ancient builders not only used advanced machines, but also understood the chemical properties of various rocks. But we are only scratching the surface of this lost technology. Why is the oldest lingam in the world also the most complex, yet the most perfect lingam? Why is the sanctum facing perfectly to the east so that the very first sun rays will fall on this lingam? Is it a mere coincidence that the Colosseum was built exactly to 6 feet, lingam to 12 feet, and the tower to 60 feet? Why was this kind of accurate measurements necessary? Why did these two structures need to have exactly 16 equal sides? What's the importance of creating them? So what do you think? Were the structures made with machines? How else could the ancient builders create a 16-faceted structure with no errors in angles 1300 years ago? What was the purpose of placing these perfect structures in specific locations of the temple? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.